Isabel, the ornaments are only for looking. Remember? Those are very expensive.
When I grow up, can I have a real tree?
Why would you want that? This one will be yours one day. Besides, real trees dry out, sweetie. This way, everything stays neat and clean. There we go. That's better.
Can we make a gingerbread house?
You know I just cleaned the kitchen. But we could get one from the bakery if you'd like. Just play quietly, and don't get your colors on the carpet.
Someday, I'm gonna have my own Christmas with gingerbread and decorations I can touch and a lot of other stuff. Help me think, buddy. Ice skating, sing caroling, a picture with Santa, and a real tree.
Perfect as ever, Isabel. You know, it just wouldn't be Christmas without that tree.
Aren't family traditions just wonderful?
Thank you for agreeing to house it, Mom.
With all those painters running around my place, I needed somewhere to escape. And I'll find plenty to do around here.
I could use a little water, dear.
Hey, is that what I think it is?
I found that in your old bedroom closet. Thought you might like to have it.
Oh. It's my old treasure box. My doll. My old building blocks. Wow, I haven't thought about these things in years.
You know, these big ones really should be on the bottom branches, right? Have you decided where you and your new boyfriend are going, by the way?
No, not yet. Brett left it up to me, but I know he'd prefer Hawaii.
And how are you two doing? Is this serious?
Well, it's fun. Too soon to tell. I think we're both thinking this would be a good opportunity for us to get to know one another better. Oh, it's my old Christmas list. Ice skate, sing carols, picture with Santa. Where did I think of all these things?
All those old holiday movies you used to love so much, I guess.
Yeah, everything I thought Christmas should be. Huh.
What? What are you doing?
Maybe we won't go to Hawaii this year after all.
Perfect Christmas town?
Perfect Christmas town. Everything I always thought Christmas should look like. Snow. I always wanted snow. Pine trees, icicles, snow. Yeah, that's what I get for spending my entire life in San Diego, right? 85 degrees in December? How is that normal?
Let's hear it for Isabel Gray, everyone, our award-winning VP of Design and the one to thank for today's celebration. To Isabel.
Isabel. Yeah, I hope you all are having a great time, and you know how much I love to organize.
Mr. Bishop. Hey, Mr. Hernandez?
Oh, put that through to my office. I'm sorry, everyone, I have to take this, but here's to you all with thanks for a great year gone by and an even better year ahead. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, goodness.
So sorry.
Oh, don't even worry about it. It's a fashion house, so luckily we have options.
Hey, everyone, there is cake.
I didn't make it, so you all are safe. Come in.
Sorry I had to duck out. Is everything all right?
Oh, it is now. I'm all done with work, and now I get to spend 7 whole days alone with this new guy I've been seeing.
New guy? Ugh, I don't like the sound of that. Anyone I know?
Brett Bishop? Maybe you've heard of him. He owns the company.
Brett Bishop. Brett Bishop designed that, Brett Bishop?
Yeah.
Lucky guy.
Mm-hmm. So, I know we talked about going somewhere hot, somewhere beachy.
Mm-hmm, right.
But I made us reservations in the most perfect Christmas town ever.
Why do I have a feeling we have different ideas about what that is?
Snow, roaring fireplaces, sweaters. Oh, and to make sure that we don't forget about a thing, I made a bucket list.
A bucket list? Are you all right? Because, you know, usually you make a bucket list if you're about to...
Not that kind of bucket list, a Christmas bucket list. A list of things you want to make sure you do before the holidays are gone. Not me. See? I started it when I was a kid. I just updated it. There are all the things I missed out on growing up.
A real tree, caroling, ice skating. These all sound very cold. What about palm trees or Santa on a surfboard?
Oh, we have so much to learn about each other. Please tell me you love it. I just so want a real Christmas this year.
What's this last one? A secret wish.
Oh, well, that one's new, but I promise you it's worth your time to find out.
Really?
What do you think?
Oh, this is great. It's amazing, but I've got some bad news. I mean, not bad news. Okay, yeah, no, it's bad. Our factory down in Rio, they got a real mess on their hands, and I have to fly down there.
South America? When? Oh, no.
If there was a way around it.
But our flights are first thing in the morning.
Well, you go without me. I'll meet you there in a few days, Christmas at the latest.
But that's days away.
I will make this up to you. I promise, okay? I gotta run. I'll call you.
Merry Christmas. guilty.
Yes, you're perfect. Look at you. You even smell like Christmas. Oh, how would you like to come home with me?
Hi there.
Oh, this one's taken for.
Looks like we have a problem.
Oh, not really, because I saw it first.
Okay, maybe you saw that side of it first, but...
Oh, this side, that side, it's all the same tree, so if you wouldn't mind just letting go.
All right, well, here's the thing. Kyle here has really got his heart set on this one, so...
Kyle?
It's Kyle, and that's Trish.
Hi.
I'm sorry, you are?
Oh, Isabel. Isabel Gray.
Hi, Isabel Gray, Jamie Houghton. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Want to come to my show?
Oh!
It's a school thing. Not now, Kyle. We're negotiating.
Well, no, we're not exactly negotiating, because there's nothing to negotiate, because this tree is mine.
Okay. Here's the thing. I'd be happy to help you find another tree in the lot.
Jamie. You don't mind if I call you Jamie, do you? You see, this may be a little bit hard to believe, but I picked out this exact tree 25 years ago.
It's very hard to believe.
I'm not kidding. This exact tree, this shape and size and color. I've been dreaming about this tree since I first knew what a Christmas tree was. You see, I'm from California.
Oh, Jamie, give her the tree.
Listen to your wife.
Actually.
This Christmas has got to be the one that I have in my head.
She's got Christmas in her head?
That's what she says.
The perfect town, the perfect cottage, the perfect holiday getaway for me and my boyfriend.
Is he in your head, too?
No, he's coming later, eventually, we think, by Christmas, most likely. He's a very busy man.
Is your boyfriend Santa Claus?
Could we get back to the tree, please?
Yes. Here's the thing. When Kyle sets his mind on something, there's just no
chance. I've got another one!
I've got another one.
I'll go. Let her have the tree. The place closes in 5 minutes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Kyle, wherever you are.
Just come to my show!
So he plays clarinet at the Christmas pageant at his school. Oh. It's the day after tomorrow. That's what that is. And it's looking like that's going to be the price for the tree, so... Are you in?
Absolutely. Sure. I'll do my very best.
Great.
Thank you.
Sure.
Merry Christmas, really.
Merry Christmas to you. Really.
So much easier in my head. Hey.
Hey. You want a hand? I got a lot of room in the back.
Oh, if I need a ride, I'll call a taxi. Bye.
Right. Are you sure it's not too big? It's a pretty big tree.
I know what I'm doing. Oh, goodness.
Oh, yeah, I can see you've got everything under control there.
Okay, fine. Help.
Only if you're sure. I don't want to impose.
I could do it myself. Really? Thank you.
No problem.
Very nice.
A beautiful tree.
Excellent choice.
All right. Hey, I know you said you have a boyfriend, right? Is that serious?
Well, we're figuring it out. We're assessing things.
Ah.
What does that mean? Ah.
Nothing. Just a regular old ah.
I have to admit, you were right. Fits perfectly.
I told you, I've been planning this forever. And the very best part is, it's completely real.
It's the first time you ever had a real tree?
Mm-hmm. My mom always thought they were too messy. I grew up terrified that Santa was going to pass our house by because there wasn't a real tree in the window.
Well, hey, maybe this year Santa's going to bring you what you really want.
Maybe he will.
What's going on over here?
Well, tree needs ornaments.
You're making them?
Some of them. I'm sure it's not the kind of construction you're used to. I saw your truck, hot in construction. You're not the only one around here who's observant.
Oh, I'm impressed. But what I am gonna do is grab you some more fuel for that fire. Nights can dip into the single digits out here. I don't want you freezing before Santa can even show up.
I am just fine. I can take care of myself.
Answer your call. I'm gonna get some wood and then I'll leave, okay?
Oh, hey!
Izzy,
hello.
Hey. Look, I just have a quick second between meetings. How's it going?
Oh, so great. Look, I got us a tree.
That one? It looks a little, you know, bare.
Well, I'm getting to that one thing at a time.
You know what? Don't worry about it. I'll take care of it when I get up there.
So when do you think that might be?
Well, I'm still going to be here for a few more days. Ah, I really, really miss you. I hate thinking of you all alone up there.
Hey, let's put it by the fireplace, okay?
Oh, yep, perfect.
Who's that? Is somebody there with you?
No, just Logman.
Logman?
Okay, you're all set. Sorry. Enjoy your stay.
I will. Thank you, Logman. Thank you very much. Say hello to your wife and son.
Oh, my sister and nephew. Yeah, will do.
Izzy. I think we have a bad connection. Isabel.
Hi. I'm sorry about that. Yes, I miss you too. Gingerbread recipe.
Boys, this could be a real barn burner.
No, there's no barring, no burning.
Stay back, ma'am. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Jamie? You're a fireman, too?
Volunteer brigade. I help out when I can. Stay here. We got this.
But there's nothing to get. What, will somebody just listen to me? Just for the record, I'm normally a much neater cook than this.
Okay. Wow. So, all this just from cooking, huh?
Well, baking, cooking.
Well, you don't need the fire department, ma'am. What you need is a cleanup crew.
Say, Scotty, she's actually a friend of mine. My shift's almost over. Do you mind if I stay here and just help clean this stuff up?
It's fine with me. Just keep her away from the oven. And future reference, you might want to consider takeout.
Thanks.
Thank you, Scotty.
You know, it was such a beautiful day, such a great morning. I woke up early, the sun was shining, there were birds chirping. It's just perfect. And then there it was, a sign, gingerbread contest.
It's an annual thing.
Of course it's an annual thing, because this is exactly what I've dreamed about, a small town, these traditional activities. And I thought, hey, why not? I can do that.
Build a gingerbread house.
Yes, exactly. And oh, I was ready. I bought everything. I got gumdrops and peppermint sticks. Fence post?
No, thanks. I'm fine. Listen, I tell you what, if it's really that important to you.
It really is.
Okay. That contest?
Yeah.
Everything's pre-baked.
Really?
Yeah, all you have to do is put it together.
You don't say.
So, if you want to drive me back into town, I can guarantee you a spot at the table.
Hold that thought.
Okay.
Mom, yes.
You didn't call last night, so I thought... What's happened to you?
What do you... Oh, that? No, I'm fine. It was just a little baking accident.
Is that a fireman behind you?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Hello.
Yeah, there's nothing going on here, Mom. Everything is all good. The fireman is going to take me to a...
To the hospital, right?
No, to a gingerbread contest.
Honey, we have a bad connection.
Listen, Mom, I need to go, so you just relax, and I will talk to you soon, okay?
But...
Bye-bye. Now, about that contest. These kids are ringers. I think he made them look bad.
I think you know one of these ringers, actually. Kyle, remember Isabel?
Don't forget my show tomorrow.
I won't.
So,
you know, there's no limit to the amount of candy you can use. It's unlimited.
Well, thank you. That's very helpful. But I'm going for a more streamlined look.
Well, mission accomplished there. You should probably add a bit more icing to your roof, though. It's going to fall off.
Whose house is this?
Which one of us owns a construction company?
Time do I have?
Not much. Tick tock.
Wow.
Contestants, that's it. Everybody, step back from your gingerbread houses.
Do you think I have a chance?
If they judge by the pound, you're golden.
Hey, seventh place. That's not so bad, right?
No. Considering there were only seven contestants, I...
Hey, you're not helping.
Hey, I know something that'll cheer you up. It's a place my mom used to take me when I was a kid.
I don't think I want to know.
You trust me?
At this point, what else do I have to lose?
That's the spirit.
Wow, this is incredible.
Right?
Where did these come from?
Well, Santa's elves actually built this. As a gift for the town over 100 years ago.
I almost believe that.
Yeah, I thought you might. So tell me, what's the fascination with the gingerbread houses?
When I was little, there was a bakery in my neighborhood. Every year around the holidays, she had this amazing gingerbread house in the window. And I just walk by it and imagine the perfect cookie woman, her perfect cookie house.
I'm gonna take a wild guess and say this cookie woman's name was Isabel.
What gave it away? Yeah. And she was a designer just like me.
Oh, really? What do you design?
Fashion. Yeah, Brett Bishop Designs.
Oh, very cool. So what you're wearing right now, did you design that?
Yeah, I did.
I love it.
Thank you so much. Me too.
Yeah.
The company design is a little bit more polished, more urban. It's not exactly where my heart is, but boy, does it sell.
Right. Yeah, here we go.
Wow.
Pretty cool, huh? So...
This is perfect.
Gingerbread Isabel.
Yeah?
She's... what?
Realistic.
Okay, so she doesn't design what she likes.
She designs what sells.
Ah.
She has her own brand, her own company. Something big, international. Oh, and that house. Probably in Paris.
Paris? Property value there is the gumdrop sidewalk alone.
She can afford it. She's wildly successful, remember?
Oh, very good.
Enough about me. Tell me about you. If you were a gingerbread man, who would you be?
Oh, my guy? Easy. Just wants to be happy, own his own business, little family, lots of
small town gingerbread friends.
All right, teach his own, I guess.
Hey, listen, after all the construction today and this horseback race, you gotta be building up an appetite. Let me buy you lunch.
You mean like a date?
No, it'd be more like a consolation prize, you know? Plus, there's that old saying, man cannot live on gingerbread alone.
Giddy up!
Here's your usual. And one for the lady on the house, seeing as it's almost Christmas.
Aww. What? Thank you, Patty.
Thank you. Wow, are you supposed to eat these or climb them?
Cute girl. Beautiful jacket.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. She's talented, too. She designed that jacket herself, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, something like that would sell like hotcakes up here.
Really?
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Even the hotcakes don't sell like hotcakes up here, Patty.
Oh, jokers. But I'm serious about this girl. Don't mess it up.
Oh, we're not together.
Oh, that's a shame. Water. I'll be right back.
Thank you. Oh, okay. Whoa, okay. Let's be honest. Who has a mouth this big?
Sorry, you were saying?
Never mind. I have to say, I still can't believe the mess I made yesterday.
Being messy is fun sometimes.
Sometimes, I guess, but it's like a road trip. It's better if you have a map, right? But
then you miss all the surprises along the way. Great job color coordinating the sugar packets, by the way. Couldn't even look at them before. You know what your tree needs?
What?
Lights.
I didn't even think of that.
Perfect.
Are we ready?
I am ready.
Okay. Here we go.
Ooh.
All right.
I think that is the most beautiful Christmas tree I have ever had.
Is it the one in your head?
Exactly.
All right. Oh, it's making me think of something I haven't done since I was a kid. We used to do it all the time. Tree this size. Do you want to try it? It's a little odd.
Considering the source, I'm not surprised.
Come on. Here. Come down here.
What are you doing?
It's not too weird, I promise. Just lie down. Come on.
And this accomplishes what exactly?
Just look up. That's what a Christmas sky should look like.
Spectacular. Thank you, Jamie. I'm very happy right now. Very tired. Very
It's worse than I thought. You asleep under the tree.
I can explain that.
And now this? It's a wonder anyone got out alive.
Mom, seriously, why are you here?
You said you needed me.
I didn't.
I listened between the lines.
What lines? There were no lines.
Look, show me to my room. We'll get started.
What room? You don't have a room. You aren't even supposed to be here.
This was on the front door. I didn't want to wake you, it says. Who's Jamie?
Nobody. Just somebody who helped me with the tree lights.
Why did he leave you under the tree like a Christmas package? And where is the boyfriend?
The boyfriend is coming.
Hmm.
Mom, seriously, you can't stay. I'm not kidding.
You know, I didn't bring the right clothes. It's much colder here than I thought. And have you noticed? It's so small. The streets, the buildings, everything is so small. And is that a real tree?
Mm-hmm.
Isabel. And the lights are all wrong. They're all bunched up.
Oh, they look right to me.
Never mind. We'll fix them later. So, where's my room?
You don't have a room because you don't live here.
So where's Brett?
Brett who? I'm just kidding. Brett's still coming, Mom. He just had a last-minute business trip.
Mm-hmm.
No, seriously, the company is growing very fast. Concessions have to be made.
Yes, but it seems like the only person making concessions is you.
That's exactly why I need this time with him, alone.
Time you're not getting.
I'm not kidding. I have to figure out whether this is just, you know, casual dating or something more serious.
Darling, let's go for a sandwich as casual. Let's spend a week in a cabin. I'm not so sure. I'm almost afraid to ask. But what's this?
Where did you find this?
Right out in the open in your dresser drawer. A bucket list?
Oh, Mom, it's not that kind of bucket list. It's just a list of things I want to make sure I do before Christmas ends.
Only Santa takes sleigh rides these days. Oh, that tree, what a mess. And the nutcracker in a town with one stoplight.
But Mom, these things are important to me. The tree, the lights.
And this. We could have had gingerbread, any bakery in town.
Well, this one had to be mine.
Your own gingerbread.
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear how that sounds? You're up here all by yourself, no friends, nothing to do.
I have got plenty to do. In fact, how do you feel about Christmas pageants?
It is so great to meet you, Ellen. Unfortunately, the timing is not great. Right, buddy?
I can't do it.
We will figure something out, honey.
Kyle was gonna play clarinet while all the ballerinas danced.
I can't do it now.
Why not? Is your clarinet broken?
Mrs. Meacham's ankle is, the ballet teacher. She was gonna lead Emma and the girls in their dance.
Been working on it for weeks.
Maybe I could talk to them.
Sure.
Hey. Wow, you sure do look pretty in that dress.
It's a tutu.
Well, it's too cute on you. Hey, I heard that you were maybe thinking about not dancing.
We can't, not without Mrs. Meacham.
You know, I used to take ballet lessons when I was just about your age.
She didn't think she was good enough, so she quit. My daughter's always been hard on herself. I don't know where she gets that.
I'm a sugar plum fairy.
Is that what you were gonna dance?
The Nutcracker.
The Nutcracker? Did you hear that?
Is there something special about the Nutcracker?
I'm not the one to ask.
How would you feel about me dancing with you?
But you don't know the steps.
Well, I know you can show me. And the rest of it, we'll just wing it. Here, let's see if these fit. It's like it was made for me. Hey, Kyle, warm up that clarinet. Because these birds are going dancing.
Yes!
Thank you.
Okay, that was amazing. Honestly, that was so good.
Oh, darling.
Oh, I loved it so much seeing you happy like that. Not even caring if the steps were right.
They weren't.
Oh, I know. Everybody knew, but it was wonderful.
Oh, thanks, Mom.
I may have been wrong about this place. It has its charms.
It does, doesn't it?
There's something you don't see in San Diego, I bet.
What are they doing?
School trip up the mountain. Local tire company supplies the tubes, and they... It's like sledding.
Huh. Sort of like sleighing, isn't it?
Dear Lord.
Mom?
You've lost your mind. She's lost her mind. Tell her.
Oh, come on. How many times are we ever going to have a chance to do something like this again?
With any luck, never. Oh, no. You want to throw yourself down a mountain? You're on your own.
Can you tell me how to get there?
Yeah, it's a locals-only place. You'd never find it. But I can take you there.
Oh, well, I couldn't let you do that.
Let the man take you sleighing if he wants to.
Sledding.
Tubing.
Whatever.
We're going.
Here are the keys.
Bye. Have fun,
I will. Right place. I don't see anybody else around.
I let the kids have their own mountain. This is my secret spot.
You sure you haven't just brought me out here to freeze to death?
Christmas time with Santa watching? You think I'm nuts?
Yeah.
So what's the story behind the sleigh ride?
What makes you think there's a story?
Because everything you do has a story behind it.
Have you ever seen the movie White Christmas?
No, I can't say I have.
You haven't seen White Christmas?
Is it the one with the elf?
No, that would be Elf. White Christmas, it's a classic. It's got Bing Crosby and Rosemary Clooney. They sing and dance and fight.
It sounds just like us, except for the singing and dancing part.
And then at the end, there's a sleigh ride and the snow comes falling down and everybody is so happy. I want Rosemary Clooney's happy ending, snow and all. Granted, at the end, she doesn't go sledding off on an inner tube.
I tell you, she does not know what she's missing. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, grab a tube.
Okay. This is something else.
Something else, huh?
It's really special to you.
Yeah. I used to come here a lot with my dad. He died pretty young, and you know, I felt the pressure to step up, be the man of the house.
How old were you?
Not old enough. Whenever I wanted time to myself or, you know, put things in perspective, that's where I came. Okay, about these tubes.
Right, what do we do?
Super easy. Throw it down, hop on it, let gravity do the rest.
Sounds like a plan.
Okay, but I want to give you a few pointers first.
Wait! I said a few pointers! Hold on!
Hold on, come on!
Hold on! Are you okay? Are you okay? Is anything broken? Are you all right?
I don't care if I broke every bone in my body. I've never been better.
You are nuts.
I know. That was awesome.
You look...
Yeah?
What?
Wait.
Sorry. That's my bad.
Just kiss a person like that?
I know. I said I was sorry.
You should be.
I'm sorry.
What?
Hey. Hey, you dropped something.
Give that back to me, please.
What is it? Christmas bucket list. Isabel, are you okay?
It's not that kind of bucket list. Why does nobody get that?
Christmas tree, gingerbread house, the nutcracker.
Oh, is that what Kyle's concert was about?
It's personal.
Sorry, I just meant
need a list to get through Christmas? I mean, doesn't that take all the fun out of it? It's the way my family usually just spends the holiday anyway.
Well, I'm very happy for you and your family.
I'm just saying, you don't need to force it, you know? Christmas has a life of its own. You just let it happen. Everything will work out.
Christmas has never had a way of working out for me. For me, it's always been about sunburns and traffic jams and overtime and too many crowds and too much stress. And for once, I would really like Christmas to just be perfect.
Good enough just won't cut it?
Nothing is ever just good enough.
I'm so sorry. That must be exhausting.
Well, I'm sorry that my life offends you, but this is the way I've planned it, and this is the way I'm living it.
No. Isabel, that's not what I meant.
Take me home.
How was the sleigh ride? You're home so soon.
What are you doing?
Well, didn't we agree the lights are all wrong?
No, we didn't. They were fine the way they were.
Well, we both know they weren't, but look now, they're perfect. Isabel, what? What are you doing?
I'm leaving. It's a stupid idea. Call Brett and tell him not to come. Instead of having hot cocoa by a fireplace, we'll have margaritas on a beach. It's probably what he would prefer anyway.
Is this about some silly lights? I thought I was
Mom,
doing something
not,
nice.
Mom, I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at myself, okay? I'm mad about the gingerbread house, and I'm mad about the lights, and the fact that I can't handle one more day of my own unrealistic expectations of myself.
Well, at least let me help you fold these.
I can't even do that right.
Sweetheart. You are so hard on yourself. You've been like that all your life, even when you were young. You wouldn't bring home your artwork, for heaven's sake.
Well, that's because I colored outside the lines.
You were five.
Well, Mozart was writing symphonies when he was five, right?
What has that got to do with this?
I'm just saying, if he was writing symphonies, he was probably coloring inside the lines.
All right, you stop this. Stop it right now, because I won't have you feeling this way. I just won't. We need to talk.
Ah, your father and I were never a good match. But I tried to make everything perfect.
You know, if dinner was waiting and the house was clean, if everything was just so...
That's how I've always felt.
Yes, but the drive for perfection is mine, not yours.
I've given you such a terrible gift.
Can you forgive me?
Oh, Mom, there's nothing to forgive.
You alphabetize your office supplies.
There's nothing wrong with being organized.
If it doesn't rule your life. It's taken me all these years to learn this. Oh. I just want you to know that the world isn't going to come to an end. If the tree lights are all wrong, and if the gingerbread house topples, and I don't want you to jeopardize what you have with Jamie because of
Brett.
Whoever. Oh. I do love you, you know.
I love you. Flaws and all.
I have flaws.
Do you want me to make a list?
No. No more lists. Oh, all right. Come on. Let's go call the airport.
No, it's okay. I changed my mind. I'm going to stay.
Oh, well, I'm not talking about you. My sister is expecting me for Christmas dinner, you know. And you have your own life to live and your own holiday to enjoy. But if you don't mind, I want to pack my own suitcases.
Deal. Oh.
Merry Christmas, Captain.
Well, if it isn't the baker.
Is Jamie around?
No. You might want to try the toy store. Toys and Treasures?
The toy store?
Hello there. Merry Christmas.
Isabel.
Wow,
volunteer firefighter, contractor, toy sales. Is there anything you don't do?
No, it's my mom's business, actually. Oh. I'm just helping out. Mom's Isabel. She's visiting from San Diego.
Hi. Ballerina.
Well,
well done. I'm Kathy. Welcome. Hi. Any friend of Jamie's is a friend of...
Well, I'm not so sure we're still friends. I owe your son a huge apology for yesterday.
You don't owe me anything. It's fine. I shouldn't tell you how to live your life. I was out of line.
If he says he was, he was.
Whose side are you on here?
You've always been an honest boy.
Santa's gone.
Oh, David. Santa and his elf just left.
Now how do you know what I want for Christmas?
I'm so sorry, honey.
You know what? Don't worry about it, because Santa always knows.
Maybe he's just gone feeding his reindeer?
He's actually gone for the day. He's back there changing.
Oh, let me see if I can go catch him.
Go.
Hey, Jamie.
What's up?
We are.
No. Hold on a minute.
It's Santa!
And I've got Jingles, my elf.
And Santa is roping for business.
Turns out that I've got time for one more visit before I fly back to the North Pole.
Yeah, so why don't you hop on up on Santa's lap and tell him what you want for Christmas?
Jeez, heavier than you. Look, David, it's David, right?
David Athenians. Santa knows my name.
Santa knows everything.
Yeah, that's right. So tell me, David, have you been a good boy this year?
I thought you knew everything.
Of course I do. I was just double checking. Why don't you go ahead and tell Santa what you want for Christmas? Oh, he's got a list. Wow, all that. Well, go ahead and tell us.
I want a video game, a Super Trooper action figure, a remote control car, a skateboard.
Why don't you just let Santa surprise you with something this year?
Why don't you just let go of your expectations about Christmas and just let it happen to you?
How about that?
No. I'd rather have a video game, a Super Trooper action figure, a remote control car, a soccer ball, and a baseball mitt.
Okay.
Quite a team, huh?
Be honest, though, did that Santa outfit make me look fat?
Well, a little bit. Excuse me. Jingles the elf here. You've reached the North Pole.
Do I have the wrong number?
No, silly, it's me. I'm just having a little holiday fun.
Oh, fun.
Oh, I so wish you were here. It's just not the same without you.
That's what I hope to hear. How's the list coming along?
It's getting there. I've got so much to tell you about. This has really been the best holiday ever. Could be better, obviously.
It will be. Listen, Christmas is still 3 days away. I'm wrapping things up here. I'll be out on the next flight. Oh, and keep that elf outfit handy. I have a few ideas I want to run by Santa myself.
Yeah? Okay.
I'll see you soon.
Bye.
Oh, that was so sweet what you did with David.
Oh, well, how many chances am I ever going to have to get my picture taken with Santa?
Not even if you planned it.
Jamie said that you're in town alone. If you're not busy, why don't you come over and have dinner with us tonight? Nothing fancy, just family.
Oh, are you sure I wouldn't be...
I'll pick you up at 7.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
so glad you could join us for dinner tonight, Isabel.
Oh, I'm honored. Such a family affair.
Hey, Kyle, did you bring your clarinet tonight? Maybe you could play us something later.
Totally.
Yeah?
And you won't have to ask him twice. He gets that from his father. A friendly warning, this one plays the accordion. And he's been practicing the 12 days of Christmas.
Don't encourage him.
Oh.
Oh, I've got Trisha's casserole.
Can I help you in the kitchen?
No!
No, no.
You told them!
I told everybody.
Wow, I can't believe you really made all these yourself.
Just like my mother taught me. And her mother taught her.
Gee, my mother always said if it couldn't be delivered, we didn't need it. That really was such a delicious dinner, Kathy.
Oh, homemade cooking is all. Some old family recipes and... Could you grab those napkins for me, dear?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Thanks.
Do these have a special significance?
Oh, that's a sentimental value. That's Jamie's first construction project. There's nothing that boy couldn't build. Yeah, it helped him through some difficult years.
Yeah, he told me about his dad.
Really? Doesn't like to talk about those days much. But those blocks, they're just like a constant reminder.
Reminder of what?
Well...
Hey, Mom, what's going on with that dessert?
Yeah, I want some pie!
Yeah, we want pie.
The natives are restless. We better get the pie in there. You grab that one and get this one, okay?
Can I get ice cream, too?
Coming!
I love this. This entire evening.
Just typical family dinner.
No, no, no. You don't understand. I was an only child. You have got an entire family of people in there who love you. You actually are that gingerbread family. You know that? Do you even know how special that is?
Well, you're right. You know, I never thought of it that way.
Look at those stars. Wow, have they always been up there?
Hiding behind your city lights, just like people when they let themselves relax. Oh, shoot. I got something for you.
What?
There you go.
What, for me?
Yeah.
But it's not even Christmas yet.
Just
it's not even Christmas Eve until tomorrow.
Just open it. It's no big deal.
Oh, my goodness. A tree? A gingerbread house? A sleigh?
Can you believe all the charms they had there and not one inner tube? Not that I could find anyway.
What's the question mark?
Oh, that's your secret Christmas wish, right?
I don't even know what to say. This is just the most thoughtful, perfect gift. I didn't get you anything.
No, I don't. It's fine. The point is, I saw something, and I thought you would like it, and so I wanted to give it to you. Good.
Well, thank you so much for everything.
You're welcome. Oh, is it important?
Yeah, it's Brett. He's in a cab on his way. Portland.
Oh. Should I bring you back or?
Probably. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Looks like he's already here. No need to walk me up.
Oh, why are you embarrassed? Is he super short? Does he have a unibrow? He's like 94 years old. You can tell me.
No, he's young and handsome and perfectly normal.
Can't imagine how sad that makes me to hear that.
I wondered what happened to you.
Hey!
Who is this?
Oh, this is a friend I met in town. Jamie Houghton, Brett Bishop.
Hey, Brett. Oh, yeah, like the company, right?
Yeah.
See, I told him all about you.
That's funny. I haven't heard a word about you.
Oh.
Why don't you come inside and join us for a minute?
No, I don't want to.
Come on, I insist.
Okay.
Let's get out of this cold. It's freezing out here.
He insists.
Oh. All right. Wow, Brett, you arranged all of this? This is so
romantic.
Sit, Jamie, grab that cushion thing there. Sorry about the wine. I specifically asked my assistant for white, and he sent red. You'll hear from me.
Off with his head. Oh, you're serious.
So you live up here, do you?
Yeah.
Yeah, Jamie's family has been so great. They've really been keeping me busy.
Well, how lucky for Isabel. I mean, I can't imagine there's much to do in a town this size. Feed the livestock, watch the stoplight change.
Ha! Yeah. Well, don't fool yourself. It can get pretty crazy around here. The library got a new book last month. Pandemonium.
Sorry about the coffee mug. They only sent two proper glasses with the delivery. What should we toast to? Small town charms?
How about to Christmas?
To Christmas.
Christmas. Cheers.
Yeah. Oh. Don't break it.
Yeah, it's...
Oh, I almost forgot. I found your list. You weren't kidding. You have been busy. I mean, look at this thing. Check, 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 check. You know, when Izzy puts her mind to something.
It's our Izzy.
Believe it or not, most of these things on this list just kind of happened.
Oh, please, you don't let anything just kind of happen. So come on, what have you saved for me?
Well, let's see here. We have ice skating and Christmas caroling. I haven't done that yet.
Okay, ice skating. We'll do it first thing tomorrow. Take it off the list and get this thing back on track. You, sir, you look like a bit of a sportsman. Do you know of a frozen lake nearby?
There is one, actually, but it's not safe to skate on it.
Oh, that's a shame. Okay, well, we'll build a snowman or make a fruitcake. I mean, it's not really that important what we do, is it?
Hey, you know, for what it's worth, there is an indoor rink in town. Doesn't open till noon, but I could probably grab you the keys, slide you guys in early.
There you go. Good man. Problem solved.
Great. I'll set that up for tomorrow. I should go. Got family waiting. And...
Yes, you should. You should go. Well, it was interesting meeting you.
Yeah. Jeez, what a surprise, huh?
Surprises all around.
Yeah.
Hey, will you please tell your family thank you for me again?
Yeah, for sure. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Okay, have a good night.
Yeah, you too.
Seventh place. I didn't know they gave ribbons for that. I do not see a future for you in gingerbread. You know, I didn't tell you about my trip. Let me tell you, once this factory is set up, we can expand into the entire South American market. Argentina, Ecuador, I mean, how is that for a New Year's plan? Looks like someone's had a long day.
Is your boyfriend sleeping in, is he?
No, he had some mysterious errand to run.
Firing assistance, trip to South America.
Nothing quite that elaborate, I hope.
but you never know.
Can I give you a hand with that?
Yes. Here. Please, I don't know what I'm doing. How did you get the key anyway?
I'm very tight with the owner.
Oh, yeah?
I used to work here when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Did a lot of odd jobs back then to help the family out. Paper route, gardening, car wash, bicycle repair.
Mm-hmm. Just till you found construction.
That's right. Building something out of nothing. It's nothing like that feeling of accomplishment, you know?
Yeah. And it's always been here. You've never lived anywhere else.
Nope. Well, college. Other than that, Fall River's been home. You know it when you find it. You wake up every morning and your heart just feels right, you know? Probably how you feel about San Diego, right?
Gosh, I can just imagine how beautiful this must be. It's filled with couples, arm in arm, twirling gracefully around each other.
It's actually just a bunch of awkward kids tripping over each other usually, but you have a very vivid fantasy life.
Well, I've heard that before. Okay.
All right. Whoa. Oh, so have you skated before?
No, I haven't skated before, ever.
All right, do you want me to come out with you and give you a few pointers?
Yes, please. Definitely.
You're on your own.
No!
Oh, my God! We're gonna fix that best.
This is fun.
You okay?
Yeah.
Looks like I got here just in time.
Oh, hey.
Hey, Brad.
Hey, you mind if I cut in?
Yeah, of course. Might need to hold on to her.
Yeah. Roses, this time of year?
Well, you know me when I set my mind to something. Hey, thanks again for setting this up, guy.
Yeah, of course. So, you guys, it's yours till noon, so have fun.
Great.
Thank you.
Oh, hey, can you put those in some water for us?
Sure.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Great. Hi.
Hi.
I know this doesn't make up for all the time we missed, but it's a start.
It's a beautiful start.
Should we do this?
Yes. Now, before we get started, I just don't feel embarrassed. It's
okay.
Really slippery. This.
I'm gonna give it a shot.
Okay. I'm here if you need me.
Something like that?
A little something like that. How did you learn how to skate?
Hey, I'm from Chicago, remember? There's nothing else to do in the winters there.
Well, it's a good point.
Shall we?
Yes.
Yeah?
Let's
check. Ooh, you got it. That's it. That's good. Really good. You have a turn?
Yes.
Whoa! Hey! This is quaint. I suppose a nice Bordeaux is out of the question.
Hey, why don't we just relax and let the holidays happen? Just let Christmas be whatever it's supposed to be. Take it as it comes.
That does not sound like you. Where'd you hear that?
Around.
Well, hello there.
Hi, Patty. Hey, this is my boyfriend, Brett.
Turkey platter special tonight. All the fixings.
What could they do to turkey, right? Okay, good. We'll take two of those. All white meat for me, no skin. Instead of potatoes, extra veggies, lightly steamed, gravy on the side. I'm sure I don't even need to say no bread, no butter.
No, you do not.
Oh, I don't suppose you've got a gluten-free option.
I don't suppose so. Is that it?
That's perfect. Thank you, Patty.
Okay, so we've got the skating thing out of the way. How soon do you think we can get the rest of this list done and just relax?
You know what about that list? We can just forget it. It's silly. I mean, it's been fun, but honestly, nothing really worked out the way I planned it.
I didn't think so. I mean, that gingerbread house, What were you thinking?
I don't know. Do you want to just head back home?
You mean it? Oh, that would be amazing. I mean, I'm sorry, but this just isn't my idea of Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Can't forget you.
Oh, Jamie, you're such a sweetheart. Well, you here to join your friends?
Hey.
Hey. Hey, guys. What was the ice?
Great.
Okay, we're heading to California.
Oh. What, before Christmas?
Fall River's a nice little town, but it's just not for us.
Right. We all always have Paris, I guess, huh?
Paris?
So great to meet both of you. Take care. If you're back this way, look me up, okay?
Jamie.
What was that all about?
I'm sorry. I'm just gonna go clear something up.
Easy.
Jamie, wait.
Hey, you know we're just friends, right? You're clear on that?
What's your point?
Well, we're very different people.
Yeah, I think we've established that several times now, probably.
Well, stop being so agreeable.
Isabel, I'm just gonna throw this out there, okay? That guy's not right for you.
How would you know?
I mean, he obviously cares about you, but he cares about himself and his work more. Who would pass up the opportunity to spend a week alone with you? Honestly, you'd have to be crazy. No apologies this time. But I promise you, I will leave you alone, if that's what you want. Is it?
Is it what?
Is that what you want?
Yeah, of course, that's what I want.
Okay. Nothing else for me to say then.
What is this?
Wait, we're supposed to open that book tomorrow.
Oh, we always open our presents Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve morning?
I've never been good at waiting. You must know that about me by now.
You would think I would, but I didn't.
Exciting. It's, a shirt.
For a fashion guy, you're pretty quick. Do you like it?
Yeah, sure, it's the right size and everything. Maybe a little woodsy.
Well, I know it's a little not your usual style, but it's perfect for the weather. It's your favorite color. I got it when I thought we were going to be up here for a little bit longer.
Yeah, actually blue is my favorite color.
Blue?
Yeah.
No way.
It's the thought that counts, and it was a very nice thought. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And now that we're opening things.
You're opening things.
Part one of your Christmas present.
Oh. Part one.
Yeah.
My goodness, what could it be?
Called in some favors. And organized a private plane to take us home today.
Oh. My goodness. That's something.
I know, right?
Wow.
I mean, this is a holiday that we can both enjoy.
No, totally. This is perfect.
I know. Let's start packing.
Okay.
Great.
So, I know we have these international fans, but I have this idea for a new line.
a Main Street boutique, my own personal design. It's more casual.
Izzy.
No, hear me out. What if the next big thing isn't global? What if it's back home, small town America? You know, we could open a separate division and do it from, well, anywhere.
I don't think so. Oh, sorry. It's a text from Hugo.
Important.
They're all important. Just one sec. What is he doing? Oh, shoot. You know what? I need to check that text. It's Hugo.
Does he know it's Christmas Eve?
He does, but apparently our new equipment doesn't.
But you know it's Christmas Eve, right?
Sorry.
I just really hoped we were going to have a chance to spend some time together.
Oh, unbelievable. He wants to shut down production for 2 weeks. No. There goes half our fabric for the month.
You know what? You deal with that. I'll be right back.
Sorry, we're just closing.
Oh, Kathy, it's me.
Oh, Isabel. Hi. Is there something I can help you with?
Oh, no, I was just passing by. My boyfriend and I are heading back to California.
Well, I got four more of these. No.
Oh, honey, I'll put those away so you two can talk before Isabel flies off to California.
Hey.
I'm really glad you're here. I was hoping you would be. I hated the way we left things yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my fault. I keep saying things around you that I don't mean.
You didn't mean what you said?
No, I did. I mean, the good things, I did. The bad things, I didn't. You can decide which is which. So, this is it, huh? You're leaving?
As the song says, I will be home for Christmas. What is with you and holiday pop culture?
I'm sorry. Well, I'm really glad you came here, even if you didn't make it to Christmas.
Maybe I'll get it right next year. Do those still sell?
Yeah, they do, actually. Always a market for nostalgia, I suppose.
I saw some like this in your mom's kitchen when I came over for dinner. She started to tell me a story about them.
Right. Well, you're not the only one with stories, I guess.
Care to share?
After my dad died, I kind of lost myself in work. You know, all those jobs I told you about.
You're doing what you had to. Just trying to help provide.
Yeah. That's what I told myself, but I was really just avoiding the feelings, you know. So I made sure I didn't have time for them.
Well, that makes sense. Nothing to be ashamed of.
No, I know that now. Because I found a set of these in the attic, and the joy just came back. Just a simple thing, stacking one on top of another. Made me realize that life isn't about a paycheck. You know, it's about living full out. It's about creating something that means something to you, leaving a bit of yourself in the world.
Yeah.
I hope that you find something like that. I truly do, because you really deserve it.
Thank you.
I gotta go. I gotta do a few things and then get home. Christmas. Have a safe flight, okay? Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Okay.
He's a good man, Isabel. And he has a soft spot for you. You challenge him. He needs someone like that. And maybe you do too.
What makes you say that?
I think it's pretty obvious to both of us.
Pilot says 10 minutes, we'll be on our way. Have I seen that jacket before?
Yes, I've been wearing it all day. Plus, you saw the sketches.
That's one of yours?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it wasn't right for the market.
Ah, right.
Hey, Brett. Did you have any fun?
Sure I did.
Like what?
The skating. That was great. Of course, we could have found her in California.
You know, I really wanted this to be such a special time, Christmas, with all the trimmings. You know how important this holiday was to me.
Look, I know that everything didn't work out exactly as you hoped, but we gave it our best, right? I know that look. Listen, I know we didn't get as much time as you'd like, but I will be with you as soon as I can see why these figures aren't adding up.
I can't go with you to California. No, not right now.
What?
Something happened to me up here.
Your business idea. You know what? That was my fault. I was too hasty. We'll set up a meeting with our distributor in the new year. You present your proposal, and I will keep an open mind. I mean it.
I know you will, Brett. That's not the point. It's not about that.
So what is it? Is it Jamie?
It's not Jamie. It's not anyone. Or if it is, it's me.
Okay. Well, I don't get that at all.
I know you don't. And I don't really get it either, but the simple truth is, you have someplace you have to be right now, and I don't. So I am going to take some time for myself.
Here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the cabin is paid for through the week.
What are you gonna do?
I have absolutely no idea. Isn't that exciting?
Isabel.
Carolers. Oh, Jamie, come on, Cal, get your jacket. Let's go.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Now bring us some figgy pudding. Now bring us some figgy pudding. Now bring us some figgy pudding.
I couldn't leave until I finished my Christmas list. Caroling?
What are you doing? I thought you...
I want to watch.
It's either them or hot chocolate with marshmallows. Your choice.
Hot chocolate.
Let's go.
So is this the end of it then?
Well, almost. I do have two bits of business remaining. I need to find a construction company to help me with a business I'm thinking of starting. I thought maybe you might know someone.
You're gonna branch it out on your own, are you?
Well, I'd have to find the right shop and the right town first.
I'm all over it. That's only one thing, though. You said there were two bits left.
Oh, I did, didn't I? Well?
Aha. Oh, right. A secret Christmas wish.
Mm-hmm. Hang on. To kiss a man I love under the mistletoe.
Is there a story behind that, too?
Not yet. But I'm hoping there will be.
Yuletide treasure. Fa la la.